This is my review of American Horror Story Freak Show, but wait, let me introduce myself to y'all. It is YouTube, what's up? What it is YouTube, what's up? Okay, let me introduce myself to y'all. My name is Jermaine, I'm a college student, and I bet y'all wondering why am I creating this channel. First of all, thanks for clicking on this video, I appreciate it a lot. Now, I bet y'all wondering why did I create this channel, and I'm about to tell y'all right now. Numero uno, to stay in touch with movies. A lot of times I'm busy with school and work, family, friends. Push my love for movies under the wayside and I don't get a chance to reflect on them and talk about them as much. So I think creating a channel would be a great chance for me to definitely build a better analysis of movies. Also meet and connect with other people who like and love the same shows I do. You know, we can discuss them. And I also watch a lot of YouTubers. Jeremy Johns, Cool Duder, Chris Stuckman. Pretty much it. Yeah, and I thought to myself, like, maybe I could do this. Maybe I can review movies and TV shows, you know? And to try to entertain you guys, to give y'all some LOL, some laughs, and all that good stuff. Let me start off by saying I'm not a critic by any means. This is just something I'm doing as a hobby. Don't take it too heavy, you know what I'm saying? As you can see in the title, today I'm going to be talking about American Horror, or should I say American Drama Story, Freak Show. And the show was here. Really here. The early episodes. You know, episodes 1 through 4, when Twisty was still around. Twisty lived up to the show's name, American Horror Story. You know, he was a big mystery. We didn't think for them to just reveal his backstory and just kill him off like that was kind of BS. But it showed that it was off of the development of Dandy. To me, he's really the only horror element on the show now. Even the freaks were more horror-oriented in the early episodes as well. Ever since Jimmy saved those little girls, it became more drama within the Freak Show. So American Horror Story Freak Show Episode 9. So I think this would be easy if I just broke down the episode character by character. So let's start with Jimmy. I mean, he's at his lowest of his lows. He's drunk. And it all makes sense because he just loves his mom, Ethel. Let's give a moment of silence for people that we lost last week. Ethel, Ma Petite, and Glory, which is Jimmy's mom. Let's give a moment of silence for them. Like a little moment of silence for them real quick. Let's give a moment of silence for them. Jimmy, he's at his lowest of his lows. He's flirting with Ima, which is the big girl that Elsa Maas got last week in replacement of his mom, Ethel. So they're flirting, you know, him and Maggie's on this. They're like up and down because she wants to leave the Freak Show. He wants to stay at the Freak Show. He's just like, nah, bro. It's like, if you want it long and hard, I need you soft and wide. I'm just like, okay, Jimmy, okay. You like the big girl. I noticed that Jimmy speaks the truth when he's drunk. He knows that Dandy was one of the clowns and accomplice with Twisty that night that them little girls was captured. So Dandy, you know, he's like, make his life a hell. And he chucks the deuces and he rides off his whip. And then we get the credits. Now let me say, I love the credits on every season of American Horror Story. I think they're freaky, scary, and they also give details about the season, which is cool. Desiree and Maggie walks in on Jimmy and Big Ima getting it in. You know, Maggie, she's upset because, you know, she has feelings for Jimmy. And he's like, she tastes just like a lemon lime lollipop. I'm just like, what? So, you know, he's simulating. We gonna keep this PG-13, you know. So, you know, Jimmy, he likes simulating these women. And they're like at the house, and he starts seeing Ethel. He's so stuck in his thought that he sees Ethel at this woman's house. So they kick him out. Guess who comes in? Dandy. He compliments the woman. He said he was gonna make Jimmy's life a living hell. He definitely stays true to that. Kills these women. And his trademark, pool of blood. One of the women's husbands that lived there. He comes home. He sees these women's bodies just floating in water. And coming from a horror aspect, the whole pool of blood that Dandy uses, I think that's interesting. You never see someone using a pool of blood as a signature move. Miles pass, you know, since he left the woman's house. He goes into his barn and he sees Beck. At first I thought, oh, okay, this is about to really happen. But Jimmy's like, no, he's in love with another woman. And Dot's like, you know, she's a lucky woman. She cries, she's upset, they leave. And, you know, Jimmy, he's going crazy. You hear hot sirens outside. Jimmy goes outside. The police catch him because he's supposed to be blamed for killing those women at the house because he left the glove there. He gets carried away, locked up, arrested, and then that's the end of Jimmy. Let's get to Dandy. I think Dandy is one of the most interesting characters this show. Because he's so insane and crazy. And you see a woman from Avon come inside and he hits her, boom, bam, he hits her in the head with a candle holder. And then we see this woman decapitated, you know, blood over the floor. And at first I thought that he was going to be swimming in her blood. He puts her head and his mother's head on one body resembling the twins. And he's like, you know, little jock dance. Oh, he's hitting the, hey, he's hitting the dance. He's playing puppeteer like, he goes back to his house after he kills these women. He makes a pool out of their blood. And Regina comes back. Regina tells him, she says she's called the police. Like, I killed your mama and my mama. And we get the music. Dun, 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 dun. He's like, this blood right here is, you know, the woman I just killed. Precious, she runs like she ran for that chicken, shorty. She ran. Danny catches her. He's like, come in. He's like, killing makes me happy. He tells Regina to take a bath with him. And he said he's not gonna kill her because she's not worth nothing. But she's like, I'm scared, I wanna leave. He said, yeah, you'll leave when I tell you to leave. Dun 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 dun. You know that music. Which was like a cool music score. Them two cues of music. He was dogging, you know. Dun, 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 dun. He just doesn't care about her no more. So he tells her, get it packed and leave. Get out. Before I kill you myself. You know, she runs out. He's really full of himself right now because he's killed all these people. He's feeling like he's the man. Brush his shoulders off. He's feeling like the man. Gina, she comes back with the police. It seems like Danny's going to confess to killing. But he turns it around and then he starts talking about his family. He starts talking about the inheritance money he has. He's like, I'll give you $1 million. If you kill Regina, he's like, okay, boom, blows her head off, man, blows this girl's head off. This was one of the most surprising things of the episode to me. Shows you, for the love of money, these people will do anything. My man's Regina, she's gone to heaven with her mom. She's gone to heaven with Doris, Bet, Dot, Stanley, and Elsa. So, you know, Bet and Dot have been hidden away in this hotel room. Elsa and Stanley find Bet and Dot from the note that Ethel left when she confessed it to Jimmy. She lures them in with the surgery. So Stanley and Elsa take the twins to the barn. He's like, the doctor's gonna do the surgery on you right here, right now. So later that night, we have a very emotional moment with Bet and Dot. Dot, she's like, she's tired of living this life together. She wants to find her one true love and do what it do. And that's like, she's scared of one of them dying, but she knows that if one of them dies, the other one can live life to their full potential. And Bet says she'd rather die so her sister can live her life. And you know, she's like, you know, we always put our heads together and solved everything together. So they eventually comes to the conclusion that they need to be together. I don't know what I was just trying to do right there. They need to be double trouble and be together. Then we got the strong man, ashamed of himself. He's about to commit suicide. And meanwhile, he sees Ma Petite. You know, he killed Ma Petite. Yes. He sees Ma Petite and he sees Ethel. And you know, Ethel, she's like, you've been strong on the outside. You know, you can lift. You're strong on the outside, but inside you always been weak, mentally weak. He can't take it anymore. He's ready. He stands on a chair, puts the rope around his neck, and he jumps off. It's like a really, really gruesome scene. And I'm thinking he's about to die. And then nope, bye. Desiree cuts him off the rope. Desiree still has love for the kid. Next week, we Jimmy getting a visit by Stanley in the jail because, you know, he got locked up. And they won't let him out. We got more freaks dying. You know, Pepper and Salt. I don't know. I'm like, he's going to die. Desiree tells Maggie, if you got anything to do with them freaks, I'ma kill you. Alright, man. That's it for American Horror Story. We on episode 9, so we probably got maybe 3 or 4 more. Also planning to be reviewing The Walking Dead when it comes back in February. A lot of TV shows I wanna do. A lot of movies I wanna review. If you stuck through this video, you the real MVP. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe. No, it feels weird saying that because I'm always watching people say like and subscribe. Now I'm saying like and subscribe. That's crazy. See y'all next time. Peace out.